this aren't like a pro. So if you are still a beginner and you still don't know what are the things that you need to know for you to actually create a good design, professional looking, elegant, and something that can really grab attention to the audience, then I guess this video is for you. Hello, boss babes and bosses out there. If you still don't know, I did a Canva workshop for the Kaplan Business School family. But before I'm going to dive in, let me share to you a quick background why I'm teaching creatives. Even though I'm studying Master of Information Technology Extension at Kaplan Business School. So yeah, way back before, I'm a freelancer. Most of the tasks that I do before is more on graphic designing. And I literally used Adobe Photoshop because wala pang Canva. Adobe Photoshop is so powerful, to be honest. But it really takes so much time to do just one graphic design. And then when I started using Canva, I really feel like it's so easy for me to design something. Like yung result ba is equivalent in using the Adobe Photoshop. So Canva is really a game changer for me, especially my main source of income is, you know, freelancing. It's really more on doing graphics. So I identified two major rules that you always need to remember when it comes to designing. The first one is storytelling, and the second one is consistency. So maybe you are asking, okay, Sui, what do you mean by storytelling? When you say storytelling, you should make sure that in your design, you are already telling your story. So how are you going to do that? The first one is to give a clear message, but with less words. As much as you can, please use less words. Okay, the second one would be focal point. Make sure that you set your focal point straight, that when someone will look at it, you will know that is the focal point. Did you get what I mean?
Okay, so you are currently seeing my screen right now. Nag-pull out lang ako ng mga samples para sa focal point so that you can understand more kung ano talaga siya and anong purpose niya. So again, a focal point is the main element in a design that draws the viewer's attention. So how can you create a focal point? So first, maybe you can use a contrast color. Lakihan mo yung text or pictures na gusto mong ma-highlight. You can also do isolation, like separate mo siya sa ibang designs. And maybe you can also make sure na yung placement niya or yung position niya is strategically directed talaga sa viewer's eye. Or maybe you can use leading lines or maybe use the rule of thirds. By the way, nag-grab ko lang to sa mga templates ng Canva here. So marami silang mga templates na. So sa poster na to, ano sa tingin niyo yung focal point? Yes, the focal point is Thailand. Kasi siya yung pinakauna mo talagang mababasa when you are going to see the design. Like, kasi siya yung pinakamalaki na text. When makita mo siyang Thailand, like, automatic, babasahin mo yung nasa itaas. Okay, trip to Thailand. After that, madudraw na sa attention mo yung ibang details. Saka mo na mababasa, okay, price is 1,200 per person na yan. Ito yung mga inclusions, blah, 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 date of departure, contact details, and so on. So, yeah, I hope that you get the point, paano gamitin ang focal point, and kung para saan siya. Another example. So for this one, what do you think would be the focal point of this design? Yes, you're correct. Nasa isip ko lang na nag-answer kayo ng NAIDOC. Yeah, that's correct. NAIDOC week. So, makakagawa ka ng focal point kung lalakihan mo yung text or lalakihan mo yung image. Now, another malaki dito na size is ito na design. So, by the way, ito ginawa to siya ni Sherry. Isa siyang contemporary Aboriginal artist. So, finiture yung illustration niya dito para sa poster ng NAIDOC Week. You can have more research dito. Meron na to siya sa Canva. Pinull out ko lang yung mga poster as a sample. So, you can also check this one if you want to know about NAIDOC. Again, this is the focal point, and then tsaka mo na mababasa yung iba after mo nakita yung focal point.
Then you can combine high quality images, photos, designs, and patterns, not just pure text. And if you remember, the second rule would be consistency, right? So the first thing that you make sure when it comes to consistency is the typography or font style. Before, I call it font style or font face. So it depends. Typography is the style of the letters that you are going to use. Technically, it depends if you are using posters or if you are displaying your design on the website, it depends. But typically around 2 to 3 combination of font styles only. Don't use more than 3 font style combinations because that would be so messy in the eyes and it would be so hard to determine what is really the message when you add more font styles, if you know what I mean.
Okay, so you're currently seeing my screen right now and you will see 5 poster templates. Again, these are from Canva. As you noticed, there are only 2 font face combinations. For the first poster, this poster is for artificial intelligence. This is a Makoto font face. You can check that one out sa Canva again. Maybe you notice na parang may smudge yung intelligence, pero Makoto pa rin yan siya. Like, font family siya ng Makoto. Sa baba, Garrett. The next one naman, Cocktail. Ito yung homemade apple. You can search that font face again sa Canva natin and then Montserrat. So magandang combination siya for something like a luxury vibe party. I would say, mafe-feel mo talaga na live shoe yung party. Ano ba yung ibang term ng live shoe? Social. Yeah. Social siya na party. And then here, you can also see it's more an art workshop. So, again, 2 combinations of font styles. Here then, same. Dalawang font styles then. And here, Neo Neon and Montserrat. Again, don't put a lot of font styles in just one graphics. If you want to highlight a text, you can use something like this. If you want something like tiny or like sleek design, you can always choose mga thin font styles. Just choose font styles or font face na babagay sa theme na gusto nyong gawin or sa message na gusto nyong i-convey or express sa mga viewers nyo.
Now, for the color scheme. So, color scheme is a combination of colors used in aesthetic or practical design. I really love doing this. If you are going to go to this link, canva.com/colors/color-palette-generator, then you can generate your own color palette. So I'm gonna share my screen, guys, in order for you to follow me the step by step on how to do this.
Okay, so this is how you are going to generate your own color palette. So you can go to canva.com/colors/color-palette-generator. As you can see here, you are just going to upload a photo and then mag-generate na sila ng 4 colors based sa in-upload mo na image.
And now, this is the styles and elements. I have here the link of the kind of elements that you can use inside Canva. There are really pretty aesthetics and design styles and elements that you can use even if you have a free account. So, if you're going to go to that link, then you can see a lot of styles and elements there. My point here is that you should be so consistent when it comes to putting elements and styles to your graphic designs. You cannot combine things that cannot be combinable. Combinable is... come on, is that a term? There are really elements that cannot be combined to other elements because it will look weird, if you know what I mean. So you have to be consistent in adding elements to your graphic designs and make sure that it's cohesive and it will look good if you add that element.
Here are the samples for styles and elements. So these are the keywords that you can actually use to research for the elements that you want to use. So for example, maximalist. The maximalist design, more is really more. And then the next one would be cyberpunk. As you can see, the elements is more on futuristic, edgy designs, more on neon twist, something like that. You can really feel that it's more digital, online. More cyber or something that you can see like it's more on the future side. And then dito naman, you can also research warm minimalism. So the design would be more softer, cozier, take on the minimalist aesthetic side. So it's more on mga leaves, thin lines or thin circles, dots, curves, something like that. And then the other one would be the vintage collage. So technically it's really like a vintage pictures or photos, cut out photos before from the magazines or from the newspapers, something like that. Again, you can go to this website. Meron siyang maraming nakalist mga keywords that you can use for your design. Okay, so this is the second time that I'm going to record this one because I just realized that na-anti na pala yung mic ko, so hindi na na-record yung voice ko. But anyways, this is just pretty quick. I want to know if you have learned something from the things that I have discussed earlier. So I have a quiz time for you guys, but I want you to participate. So I have prepared 3 sets of poster for you to choose what's the correct poster that should be used for that event or for that topic, should I say. But before I'm going to give you the poster, this is just a disclaimer that I just grabbed some of the photos there from Google. Some of it we also create on our own, but a lot of it we just really grab it for an example to what's the best kind of poster and what is not. So yeah, this is the first poster, this and that edition. Poster number 1 is for music festival. So if you think that this poster here is good for a music festival or that, type this if you think that this poster is the correct one, and type that if you think that this poster here is the correct one. And then don't forget to put your answer. Why do you think that poster gives a clear message and is really, really good poster for a music festival? I'm gonna give you 3 seconds. 3 seconds. Okay, just pause this. Okay, pause. The next one is for piano lesson. So which poster do you think is the best for a piano lesson? This poster or that poster? Again, it's just the same. Just type this if you think this is the best poster, or that if you think that, that is the best poster for the piano lesson. And don't forget to include why you think that that poster is the best for a piano lesson. The last poster would be a Midsummer Night Show. Which poster do you think is the best? This or that? It's just the same. If you feel like this poster is the best, then type this. And if that, then type that. Don't forget to include your reason why. I really, really hope that you enjoyed this quick tutorial. As promised, I'm going to flex the output of my students during the Canva workshop. Here you go. So yeah, that's that. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I really, really hope that you learned something from me. If you like this kind of video, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the bell button so that you'll get notified every time I upload a new video. And like our Facebook page at BossofPH, follow us on our Instagram accounts at BossofPH and at Briksui, and you can also join our Facebook group, I'm Ready to Boss Up by Briksui. Also follow me on my LinkedIn, which is Susie, and LinkedIn page BossofPH. So yeah, hope to see you on my next one. Bye.